Hello, today I will show you how to create a simple subscription rule in the Seal Subscriptions app. I will set the rule which will allow customers to start a simple monthly subscription for one of my products. The subscription rule allows you to configure how and which kind of subscriptions you are prepared to accept in your shop. It's quite an amazing and powerful tool and feature for your business because you're just going to love the amount of possibilities you have with setting up subscriptions for your products. You will need at least one subscription rule in your shop to start accepting subscription orders. So let's start by opening the Seal Subscriptions app in your Shopify store. So here I am on the Shopify dashboard and I can see the Seal Subscriptions app here. So I'm going to click into it and this will open the app. And now we can see the dashboard up here with all our navigation buttons. And I'm going to click on subscription rules. Here you will see all the subscription rules you have configured. You can always edit and add new subscription rules here. As I've just installed this app, there aren't any subscription rules yet. And the widgets in the shop are disabled. Now, let's start configuring our first subscription rule by clicking on the Create Rule button. Here, we have to first choose if we want to create an auto-charging subscription rule or a recurring invoices subscription rule. The auto-charging subscription rule will allow you to automatically charge your customers, while the recurring invoice subscription rules will allow you to automatically send your customers an email reminder with a payment link for each subscription renewal. The recurring invoices rule won't automatically charge your customers, and this is a key point and something you should really think about when you're setting up your subscriptions. But in this tutorial, we will focus on auto charging rules. So I'm just going to go ahead and select that option now. The first thing we will see here is the rule name. This name will be visible to your customers in your shop next to the add to cart button. You can leave it the way it is right now if you're happy with that. That's the default setting, or change it to anything else. We'll see how this shows up a little later on when we look at the front end of the shop. The second thing that you can deliver is the deliver every text. This text will show up when the customer selects the subscription option in the widget and will be followed by the delivery options that we will set up in a little while. For example, it will show up as delivery every month, where the month will actually be a drop-down selector with all the delivery options. For example, month, 2 months, every week, etc. You will see this a bit later on in the video. Okay, now we're at the important part. We have to select the products that we want to use for our subscriptions widget. So we're going to go ahead right now and choose those products. So we can do that by coming over here and clicking on this blue select products button. This will then bring up a list of the products that we want to use and that we want to have the possibility of our customers choosing a subscription for. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the bag of coffee because that's just the one I want to add in today's demonstration. So we can see under products available for subscriptions that my bag of coffee has been added. Now let's configure the delivery options or selling plans as we call them. So one of the first things you'll notice here is the selling plan name is pre-filled. It says weekly subscription. So I'm going to change this to monthly subscription. And now let's configure the delivery interval. What I have to do here is just change the delivery interval type from week to month. And what's nice about this is you can also change the number here as well. So for example, if I want to bill my customer every 2 months, I just change this number to 2 instead of 1. I'm just going to change it back to 1 for now. Next up, we need to change the selling plan selector label. actually, if we look at this and we go to change it, we'll notice something. Look, it's already changed. It was a week before, but when I changed the delivery interval from week to month, it updated by itself. So I'll just show you that again, show you how that works. Isn't that cool how that works? And you may be wondering why this is important, because this label will show up, the label of month will show up in the selector when your customer's choosing their subscription plan. So it is important to set the right value here so they actually understand what they're signing up for. We will leave the day on which the customer should be charged on its default value. This setting allows you to select a day of the week or month when you want to charge your customers. For example, you can charge all your customers on the 15th of the month, but we're going to leave that for another tutorial. Let's talk about requirements. Requirements is a really powerful feature inside the Seal subscription app. This allows you to specify the minimum amount of payments you're willing to accept for your product, and also the maximum amount of payments you're willing to accept. It's a really powerful feature. Let's look at how it works inside the app. So here we've got minimum number of payments, which is set to unset at the moment, which is actually the default position, as in it's not been set what the minimum number of payments is. You can click here and specify how many you want to set as your minimum. And remember, this is related to your delivery interval, which you've specified earlier on in this plan. In this plan, I've specified I want payments to be made on a monthly basis. So if I clicked two, then it would require a minimum of two monthly payments from the customer. And over here, we've got maximum number of payments. So perhaps I want to make sure that they sign up to 6 months. So again, I would come down here and click six, but the default mode is unlimited. Now, let me give you a quick example of how you could use these. Perhaps you sell a quite expensive item on your site, maybe a piece of furniture, and perhaps you offer a payment plan to people so they can afford to purchase it, which makes it much easier for you to make the sale. Perhaps you want to give them the option for paying over 6 months. Now, the way we can do this with requirements is set our minimum number of payments to six, and then we can set our maximum number of payments to six. So this means the person must pay the 6 monthly installments, but they also won't pay any more than that because we've set the maximum number of payments as well. For the rest of this demonstration, I actually don't need a minimum or maximum payment, so I'm going to set both of these back to their default position. Now we're going to look at the discount section. So we want to give them a bit of an incentive to start a subscription in our shop, and we can do this easily by offering a subscription discount. So if you sign up for a subscription, you get some money off. Let's first select the discount type. I'm going to click down here where it says discount, and I'm going to click percentage discount. You actually have three different options here. You have a fixed amount discount, percentage discount, and fixed product price discount. But today I'm going to select percentage discount, and I'm going to give my customers 10% off when they subscribe. And now here is the amazing thing I can do with discounts. I can increase the discount for my loyal subscribers. To do this, I just have to enable the option to change the discount after a specific number of payments. So to do that, I just come down here and click the button here, and I'm clicking that next to the text which says change discount after specific number of payments. And I really like this feature, because who doesn't want to reward their loyal customers? It's a win-win for everyone. Now a few more advanced options have shown up, and this is what I really like, because I can configure these loyalty discounts to work exactly how I want them to for my store. So what I'm going to do first of all is change the discount after setting. So at the moment it's on initial order, so that's not really a loyalty discount at the moment. Instead, I'm going to change it to the fifth billing cycle. What that will mean is after the person's made the initial sign up and payment on the store, and they've made another 4 subscription payments, they'll then be into the loyalty discount phase. Okay, so on their sixth payment, they'll start getting a discount on their orders. And now we can set the amount of discount. So again, we can charge fixed amount discount, percentage discount, or fixed price discount. I'm going to set it as a percentage. And lastly, over in the adjustment value, I'm going to put in an amount of 15%. So I'm going to offer my loyal customers a nice chunky 15% discount when they stick with me for a decent amount of time. Now, this is a good deal, which my customers won't be able to refuse, will they? They will definitely want to sign up for this plan. And to let them know about this, I'm going to write a description for my selling plan. And this is important because this is going to show up on my product page. I've already written mine, so I'm just going to copy and paste it in here, but you can add whatever you like into this field. Okay, this is looking great. Now, I also want to give my customers an option to start a bi-monthly subscription. I'm going to configure this by adding another selling plan to the rule. To do this, I just click the Add Selling Plan button here. Right, and that's added another selling plan. So we can see it says selling plan number 2. So we can quite clearly see this has been added. If at any time I want to delete this additional plan, I can just click the remove button over here. And that will remove it for us. So now let's quickly configure the bi-monthly option. So I'm going to call this my bi-monthly subscription. Okay, so that's gone in there. And I'm going to add this subscription as a longer interval. So this is going to be bi-monthly, so 2 months. As this is a longer interval subscription, I will only give my customers a 5% discount. But I will increase it to 10% after the fifth billing cycle. So I'm going to click the button here again. So under where it says automatic discount modification, I'm going to click in here and I'm going to change it after the fifth billing cycle, and percentage discount is correct. That's what I want. And then I'll just change it here to 10%. Okay, and now I need to add a description here to make it nice and clear and attractive to people when they're thinking about signing up. So I've copied and pasted mine in here. 5% discount after fifth payment, you get 10% on all renewals. Cool. Right, so now everything is configured and now we want to go ahead and save everything. To do that, I just click on the Save Rule button on the bottom of the page. Okay, it's saved. This is great. Now let's go and check out our rule. So we can do that by scrolling up to the top of our page and clicking on the subscription rules button at the top. See right up here, there's a bit of text up here that's actually a button. So you can click there. It will take us to subscription rules. And we can see we now have a rule in this area which says subscribe and save. Now, you can always edit your subscription rule here, or you can even delete it if you need to. So you can edit it by clicking on the edit button here. I'll show you that just takes you back into the rule and then jump back out again. Or you can delete it by selecting subscribe and save and hitting the delete button. But I'm not going to do that right now as I want to have my rule active. Let's check out how our subscription widget looks when it shows up on our product pages. We've got our bag of coffee product here, and at the moment we've got it selected to show one-time purchase. And then actually neatly below it, we can see the subscribe and save option. And this is actually our plugin in action on the front end of the site. And it looks great and it looks really aligned and in brand with the theme on the store as well. So that's very cool. Let's click on the subscribe and save button, and that will give us our subscription options that we set up in the subscription rules in the back end of the store. At the moment, it's set to deliver every 1 month, and we can see the price is €22.50. But if I change it to 2 months, then the price will go up slightly because we haven't given people quite as good a discount to €23.75. So we can see how the price automatically updates on the front end as well. And what's nice about this is not just the price updating, it's also the text below also updates as well. So it's all contextual and all makes sense with the options people are choosing. And if I add it to the cart now, okay, and then I go to the cart, we can see the bi-monthly subscription is added here under the product description. So that's really clear to the customer what they're getting and what they paid for. And then if I go to checkout, you can also see the selling plan below the product title there as well. All right, that's it. So in this video you watched, you just learned how to start your subscription business by creating a subscription rule in your sales subscription app. You learn how to create a subscription rule, how to add products in the subscription rule, set up different interval options, set a discount on a subscription rule, and how to validate that the widget shows up correctly in your shop. I hope that you liked the video and it helped you clear any doubts you might have had. Now open the Sales Subscriptions app in your shop and configure your first subscription rule. Have a great day.